It's Game Boy Works, and this is Mr. Chin's Gourmet Paradise. We've seen a handful of Game Boy titles that had sequels on NES, most notably Capcom's spectacular Gargoyle's Quest. But of all the games ever to appear in this particular category of Game Boy history, I'm almost positive that the most unlikely, or at least the most little known, has to be ROMStar's arcade-style platformer Mr. Chin's Gourmet Paradise. Assuming, of course, that this actually is an NES prequel. See, the eponymous Mr. Chin also appeared in another game released on NES by the same publisher right around the same time as Gourmet Paradise debuted, Thunder and Lightning. But the actual origins of, and relationship between these two games is fuzzy at best. Gourmet Paradise appears to have shipped in the US in September 1990, with a planned Japanese release for the following year evidently having been scrapped. Meanwhile, Thunder and Lightning looks to have showed up in both American and Japanese arcades in December 1990, with the NES version appearing around the same time. A Famicom version, called Family Block, dropped midway through 1991 in Japan. So by all appearances, Mr. Chin's Gourmet Paradise launched before Thunder and Lightning, but Thunder and Lightning was co-developed by our friends at Seta and a company called Visco, which has long since abandoned video games in favor of manufacturing TVs and slot machines. Meanwhile, Gourmet Paradise has no in-game credits, and its developer is unknown. Online sources listed as ROMStar, but that seems unlikely. ROMStar, a California-based company, existed entirely to publish and distribute Japanese arcade and console games. To my knowledge, the company never actually created games, so taking this one foray into Game Boy development seems unlikely. This is one of those cases where obscurity and a profound lack of interest by the general public makes it almost impossible to fully understand what was going on here. But if I were to make a guess, I'd wager that ROMStar had the unlikely idea to create a mascot character out of the protagonist of Thunder and Lightning, and either commissioned a game based around him, or, more likely, grabbed the rights to some mediocre work-in-progress Game Boy platformer and said, "Hey, could you go make this hero into a mildly racist Chinese caricature?" Aside from Mr. Chin himself, Thunder and Lightning has almost nothing in common with Gourmet Paradise. The former is an Arkanoid clone that swipes its presentation gimmick from the bonus screens of Nintendo's Pinball for NES. You know, the mini stages where you play Breakout to rescue Pauline, with Mario holding the Breakout paddle aloft over his head. Thunder and Lightning was a very direct lift of Arkanoid, swiping a lot of elements of that game, such as power-up capsules that would descend from broken blocks in the playing field. It's not bad, although it would be more fun if Visco and Seta had gone all in and integrated support for Taito's Vaus controller for NES. Gourmet Paradise, however, plays more like a game in the Mario Brothers vein. A steady stream of enemies pours onto the screen, and Mr. Chin has to defeat them with his limited capabilities. Specifically, he transforms them into peaches and eats them. I guess this is where the Gourmet Paradise name comes into play, although it's kind of a stretch. The only food here are peaches, which enemies turn into. And not just any peaches, but ambulatory peaches. It's kind of weird. The game works like this. Enemies wander and waddle around the screen, and as many as four can appear at a time. They're deadly to the touch, but Mr. Chin can lay down small barriers that obstruct the monsters. Once you place two barriers on the same level, you can transform any enemies trapped between them into peaches to collect and eat. The more peaches you devour in a row, the higher the point multiplier you earn. 200 points, then 400, then 800, and finally 1600. There are a few minor mechanical details to make note of here. You can smash bricks by leaping into them, and certain types of floor are permeable to Mr. Chin, but not the monsters. Also, every third stage is a bonus level in which walking peaches march across the stage, and you need to collect as many as possible. And finally, you don't earn points, you collect calories. It feels like they were reaching pretty hard for some sort of novelty here, but it didn't quite pan out. Mr. Chin's Gourmet Paradise may represent ROMStar's attempt to create a corporate mascot by dropping him into a Mario Brothers clone, but there's a reason we never saw a Super Mr. Chin's Gourmet Paradise. As a protagonist, Mr. Chin basically looks like Anpan Man, transformed into a doughy Chinese stereotype. And as a game, Gourmet Paradise lacks the substance of a true great. It consists of eight endlessly looping stages that never feel particularly difficult outside of the somewhat stiff controls. At the very least, it would have been more interesting if ROMStar, or whoever developed the game, had stolen Mario Brothers' best feature, its multiplayer action. The game's central mechanic, which involves surrounding enemies with traps, begs for cooperative play and mutual sabotage. It's nowhere to be found here, though, and Mr. Chin's Gourmet Paradise is simply another forgotten, unremarkable Game Boy release by an anonymous developer and a long-vanished publisher. Its ties to an equally forgotten NES game, enigmatic as they may be, haven't helped Mr. Chin's Gourmet Paradise remain in the public consciousness either. What a strange little blip in video game history. Next episode, we dive even deeper into the waters of obscurity. Game Boy works may not survive the journey.